everyone, and welcome to AgriTalk. It's day number three of the Farm Progress Show in Decatur, Illinois. And yes, despite the fact it's supposed to hit 102 today, there are people on the grounds, not as many as the last couple of days, but still, the crowd is here, and they are enjoying, actually, a breeze. So it's not too bad this morning, and they can get around pretty easy. So, really, it's not a bad time to be at the Farm Progress Show. We'll see this afternoon. It may really thin out in a hurry, but up till now, wow, two huge days attendance-wise. Let's talk about it as we broadcast from the Robo Agri-Finance exhibit here at the Farm Progress Show. Matt Jungmann is with us, National Events Manager for Farm Progress. You knew this would be a light day anyway, and of course, with the 100-degree temperatures, you knew that was going to affect the crop.
Well, it certainly does. You know, I think that the forecast maybe affected the first 2 days attendance. You know, we had that Wednesday was what you expect. It was a great big day. Tuesday was the surprise. It was a lot bigger than what anybody had anticipated. So that was really great. I think, you know, it's fair to say the exhibitors would call Tuesday and Wednesday make a successful show, and anything that we get today is just kind of nice topping on the cake.
I thought Tuesday was a bigger than normal opening day, and yesterday was a normal middle day.
That's exactly right. Tuesday was about 15% bigger than the 2009 Tuesday, the last time we were here in Decatur. And then yesterday was about 2% under that record-crushing day of 2009. So, you know, obviously that means we're way up on crowd versus a normal show. So, and good weather, those two good days of weather make for a great show. And today, it's actually not bad this morning going out there, but, you know, this afternoon it's going to get hot.
And you had a big crowd at the concert last night.
A great concert last night. Biggest concert we've held after the show. You know, we had a real big concert in 2003 with Brad Paisley, and this one was bigger by probably 1,500 people. It was a nice night. It came off on time, and we got everybody out of there safely by 9 o'clock at night. So it was just a really nice night last night.
How about Adam Fields? How's the harvest demonstrations going?
Harvest is going great. Because of the heat this afternoon, we bumped the schedule up a little bit. So we just kicked off the field demonstrations just a few minutes ago, an hour early, so that we can get the operations done and then get everybody back in here. It's pretty hot out there, so we want to make sure that we're making the right decisions to keep everybody safe.
Yeah, and the challenges that farmers are going to have this fall where it's dry, you're dealing with that out in the fields here, too. You have to watch, you know, you don't want to have a combine fire or anything like that, so you're constantly on the watch for that.
Well, that's right. And something that's interesting, actually, is that the exhibit field that we're in here is Decatur Fire, officially Decatur Fire. And then when you get out to the field demonstrations, you cross out of the city limits. And so that's rural fire coverage out there. So the local rural fire coverage is out there dedicated to field demonstrations and following them. So it's kind of nice that we're double covered with two teams here. So everything, there aren't any problems, but we want to make sure that if something were to arise, we have it covered.
Okay, let's look ahead. A couple of weeks, we'll be in Grand Island, Nebraska for Husker Harvest Days. How do things look there?
Things look great. You know, I just sat down and looked at the forecast, and it looks like this heat is going to break, and we're going to have beautiful weather out there for setup. The crop has come along. They've got enough heat to crank the crop along. We were a little worried about it midsummer, but it's come along real well. Field demonstrations are good. We've expanded the show site again, and, you know, so some more exhibits on the show site. Just shaping up to be another great show. A lot of those big introductions that happen here on Tuesday are loading up on semis and heading west down I-80, and they'll be unveiled out there, too.
Semis are waiting outside the gates ready to get in and do that. Let's look ahead to next year when we go back to Boone. Will we see anything different there?
We are working on a couple of things that could be really, really great improvements to the site. There are a couple areas a couple things we can do to make that Boone site a great improvement, and we're kind of working on those, and you know, we're not ready to say exactly what they are, but I think we're going to have plenty for folks to see when we get there.
What's the schedule here the next few days? How does this one come down?
Well, according to the exhibitor manual, everything has to be out of here a week from tomorrow, the 9th. Now, obviously, not everything's going to be able to get out, but there will be an exodus out of here at 4 o'clock tonight. And, you know, about 60% of the iron that's here on this grid will disappear by dark tonight. And then tomorrow's a hectic day, a little bit of work on Saturday, and then it really calms down, and most everybody sends everybody home for Labor Day. And then Tuesday, Wednesday, it'll pick up kind of on a steady pace to get everything cleared out by Friday. And then about that Friday is when the landscapers get real serious about taking these wood chips out. The tents will be coming down. That kind of thing.
So they ask me, what do they do with all these wood chips?
Well, the locals, for folks in the local area, the landscapers have a sale on Saturday in a couple of days where they'll sell all these plants and these wood chips and that kind of thing. You know, you're talking hundreds of semi-loads of wood chips. And so there's a cogen plant at ADM where they mix this with coal and burn some of the wood chips, the leftover wood chips, so they certainly don't go to waste.
Did not know that, so that's interesting. It's sure a lot different than the old days when you have to come in here and whip this exhibit field and get it ready for farming next year.
It certainly is. It makes it, well, yes, it is, but in the old days, you know, if there were some ruts or there was a little bit of grass torn up, that just didn't matter because we were coming in and ripping it, so it'd be 18 inches deep and you just make problems, you can bury problems. So it takes a little bit more finesse and get it back into shape because however we leave it is what we're going to find when we come back in 2 years. We want to make sure that there's a good footing in the grass. We've got to get seeding and that kind of thing. So it's a extensive process. We'll be out here for a month. Somebody will be out here for a month making sure that this place gets back into shape.
Well, good to talk with you. Thanks for letting me be on Matt Radio every day here during the show, and we appreciate the effort.
I appreciate it, Mike. Thank you.
Matt Jungmann, National Events Manager for Farm Progress. A successful show, even with a lighter crowd today. It's already had two big crowds, and there's still folks here certainly today. So a successful Farm Progress show. And next, we'll turn our attention to Husker Harvest Days in Grand Island, Nebraska. Poll question this week, how would you describe your beef and pork purchases right now? Are you cutting back? Are you buying less expensive cuts? Are you buying more poultry? Are you buying the same amount of pork and beef, or are you buying more? Log on and vote at agritalk.com. All right, we have officers of the National Corn Growers Association will be joining us next here at the Farm Progress Show. This is AgriTalk.